Hello, friends. Happy Tuesday. Welcome back to the Tempting Cave. Boo's got a brand new magic spell. Also, it looks like it refilled my magic after I did that. That was nice of it. I took care of that guy forever. Let us proceed on our quest. Hey, stuff. Wow. I'm rolling in small gems. And large gems that are worth multiple small gems. Okay. So it's not as some... Oh, right. That's just a teleporter. Huh. Yeah, there's no reason pushing a block on top of that would do anything. I wonder why these are blocks at all, then, instead of just more cave wall. Like, is this... Like, if I step on that, is this going to be a permanent shortcut, or... is it just going to put all the blocks back in place? I'm expecting it's the latter. Yeah, it just puts all the blocks back in place. Sorry, I have to pause for just a moment. I will be right back with you. Alright, recording unpaused. Ready to jump back into action here. And slowly work my way back to where I just was. In hindsight, fighting that teleporter, probably not the wisest move. Oh, well, at least that door's still open. It is curious, though, like, why they made those moving blocks at all. I would think there must be a reason for it, but maybe not. Or maybe the reason will be revealed and I just need to be slightly more patient. Oh. Yeah, that wouldn't have helped anyone. Click. Heck off, you. Refill 1 point of magic for Umi there. I am going. I'm going as fast as I can. Our sprites are chibi, so their legs aren't very long. No. Fall into the bottomless abyss. All right. I am back on track. I am not going to step on that teleporter. However, I will push these blocks around a little bit and try to figure out if there's a reason for doing so. Probably not. Who knows? Bah! How is this possible? Don't you understand how to follow instructions? I don't need your help. I have the situation in this cave totally under control. Wah! Said Tiny Hand to Strombath. Look at him. He can't even stand up. What happened? Did you see something that frightened you? For him to be shaking like that, it must have been pretty scary. Well, this seems like an important platform. Alright, you heard the song, let's go. My finger is on the key for dialogue mode. Oh, this music rules too. Monster. Okay. The monster has nothing to say. It actually, it looks kind of like Sinister, like the middle part. It's a Sinister spider. If you're not familiar, Sinister is an old arcade game where there's a giant monster spaceship who taunts you. And it looks kind of like a lion head thing, sort of. I don't know, it's just kind of generic fantasy monster-esque. But, it's like the spider is weirdly reminiscent of Sinister to me. I don't know. Maybe I'm losing it. I mean, Sinister wasn't like a Sega game, so it's not like they would be referencing one of their own old arcade games. Let's give magic a try. I think Sinister was Williams. Well, I hit it. Wonder if that did more damage than just an arrow attack. I would think so. I think I hit it. Alright, good job, y'all. Back into reserves. Who can take care of the rest? I kind of want to save my magic for healing purposes. I do have that potion, but it would be better not to use it if I don't have to. Save it for a rainy day. Oh! Aw, I thought it was about to explode. Maybe turning white like that means it only has one or two hit points left. Ah! Oh no! That did 2 points of damage. I should have been paying closer attention. Alright, Umi and Hikaru, it's up to you. Who is a floating zombie with a bandage on her head? She's out of commission. Come on. Ow. Ah, crud. Well, this isn't going so well. I might pop the potion. Actually, yeah, I have one hit left with both Umi and Hikaru. Well, I guess I should wait until I have one character left and see if it is a full party revive. So, if Mumu goes down, then I'll try the potion. I mean, it's there to be used, right? Ah, it's angry now. Heck yeah! Oh no, it's tiny. Is it still dangerous? Okay. Yay, Fu's back in action. Magic Knights, I beg of you, please accept my apology. I made the barrier to protect the village and was pampered for my efforts. But when monsters started filtering into the village, my reputation suffered. And then, you arrived. I felt threatened from all sides. I knew if you defeated the beasts in here, my reputation would be crushed forever. That's why you've been such a royal pain in the butt? Interesting phrasing, but yes. Well, okay. Everything solved. Monster's dead. Let's go. Hooray! And there was never any trouble again in Palizu Village. Aw, everyone came out to thank us. You've all been waiting out here for us? With the legendary magic knights fighting for our village? Of course we waited. You'll be relieved to know that the beasts are... gone. Thanks to Lukino here, our services weren't necessary. He's a great magician. Aw. Why, that's fantastic. You really are the greatest spellcaster in all of Sephiroth. This calls for a celebration. Everyone, escort Lukino back to the village. Aww. Well, that's our good deed for the day. Hikaru, don't you think your lie will hurt Lukino in the end? Well, Hold on, Umi. The important thing is that this lengthy ordeal is no longer on his conscience. If he doesn't feel any shame about it, that's his concern, not ours. Besides, with that reasoning, we can skirt the whole issue of white lie morality. Even so, up until now, he's been protecting this village. He can't be all that bad. Yeah, I guess you're right. I wonder if this good deed earned us any brownie points. Level up. Aww. She grew as a character, so her strength, her stats grew as well. Arachnidia was my favorite pet. Those girls will pay dearly for killing it. I just have to figure out why they were so nice to Lukino after what he did. It has to be an act. They cannot be that sweet. So, her Escudo is level 2. I think there may be a mechanic I forgot about. I'm just gonna poke my head back in here real quick, try something. Oh, well, that's nice of it. So that makes me think there must be something in here worth getting if it gives me a teleporter. Do I have to fight the boss again? Surely not. No, it just switches to the awesome music. Okay, so her basic attack is indeed stronger. And also, you can hold the attack button. And when Fu holds the attack button, she gets 3 arrows instead of 1. Totally forgot about that until just now. I was like, wait. Yeah, our weapons were supposed to have powered up, weren't they? And yeah, that's what Escudo level 1 does. It gives you that little charge attack. And now that Hikaru's Escudo is level 2, her basic sword swipe attack is better. And she has this little, So that's neat. I am a little curious why it has the teleporter back here. Like, maybe it's so I don't think I need to come back in here and see if there's any treasure that I missed or anything. It's like, yeah, here's the boss room, there's nothing else here. You don't have to waste your time backtracking back there. Or maybe I come back here again later for some reason. Oh well. Anyway, the important thing is we got to hear that music again. And now all of Polizu Village's problems are solved. And yeah, they sort of heat seek on enemies. So yeah, that would have been really useful through this dungeon. And I think with Hikaru, now that her weapon is more powerful, like even the basic attack does more damage to enemies. So, that could be a reason to the horse monster takes 2 hits to kill now with Hikaru. That thing only takes 1. So yeah, definitely a more powerful attack. And then Fu, I think her weapon does the same amount of damage as before. But she now has heat-seeking arrows, which is pretty cool. Or, you know, monster-seeking arrows. We do. Lukino's a changed man. Wow. Real great attitude, buddy. Out of my way. I thought this was where the cranky teacher dude lived. Did he move? Or maybe it's this house. Yeah, this is where he lives. You still cranky? He's still cranky. I mean, he has a character portrait, so he must be important. Also, why is this area here? Oh, this is where the evil kid was hanging out for a little while. Okay. Alright, well, time to go talk to Lukino, see if I get a reward, talk to the village elder, see if I get a reward. Well, I guess I was off base about that prediction. Oh, I can't believe you turned out to be the Magic Knights. I spent all that time primping for a pack of teenage girls. Okay. Hi. Reward, please. You don't have to say a word. I know what you did for Lukino, and it was sweet. Aww. Well, that's the best reward of all. Satisfaction of a good deed. So, I've been thinking a lot about how I acted. I was narrow-minded and selfish, and I gave you girls such a hard time. From now on, I'm going to change my ways and do the best I can for these villagers. Yay! I'm sure your help must have been necessary for him to have defeated those monsters. He's always been good with magic, but even he couldn't have done that alone. Nevertheless, this has been for the better. Now he's trying hard to be a great magician again. And that's the Lukino I know and love. Aww. Everything worked out okay. Now... oh, there's like a jewel over there. that I missed. Or maybe I just can't get to it yet. Ow. Still can't get across here. Yeah, I haven't gotten any kind of, like, mobility or traversal powers. Anything new in the item shop? Nah, I don't want these. Although, if I had a magic potion, I wouldn't have to grind the next time I need magic for a plot trigger. Of course, now that I know, that hopefully shouldn't be an issue again. Okay. Yeah, I must eventually get something that allows me to get that. Because as it is, it's just sort of floating in the middle of the water. Okay, well, Clef, any idea what I should do now? It seems as if your swordsmanship has improved, Hikaru. However, it must improve more. To unlock the true power of the Escudo weapon, you must work to improve your skills. I trust that you will find the way to perfect the union of mind and body, Magic Knights. I trust that you will help us. Improving the Escudo weapons is important, but never lose sight of your true quest. We know. I think Precia said that we need to head north to the sea. Okay. Well, that's just as good a lead as any, I suppose. So yeah, there was another way I could go north that was blocked off before. Now that the monster situation is under control, you're free to come and go. Alright. Yes, the goblins. Taflon by the sea. What a nice quaint sounding little village. Okay. So, Palizu Village, so it was sort of wind-themed. Like, the trees were rustling, and then Fu ended up getting powered up in the dungeon. So since this one is water-themed, I bet this'll be something for Umi. I love monsters. Uh-oh. A giant dragon? Would that be related to those machines Clef spoke of? He did mention sea. There's only one way to find out. We'll have to make our way to that island. I have lots of questions. It is a nice design. Hikaru is not stoked. Ah, jeez. Just some miscellaneous stuff. Altus, eh? Whoa. Check out that transition. That's the power of the Sega Saturn. Why is there an island in the sky? Sweat drop. Alright. No reason for that room to exist. Seemingly. Did I examine this pot? Just an oversized pot. Hello. Uh-oh. This sounds like another job for the Magic Knights. I mean, I guess. That seems like the next logical place to go. Heltus, eh? Breathtakingly boring. That's a little much. A portrait of the zigzagging plant. What, this plant? Very strong opinions. Okay. We are gathering the information that we need. We're building up her notebook. References. Haha, oh foo. Oh Hikaru. Oh Umi. Well, my detective skills are not revealing any important clues in this house. What about this rolled up piece of paper? Must be the rag that kept this place so sparkly and clean. It's just a rag. Alright, that is not an important note left by the previous occupant. With a forwarding address. It does suck. You. Hello to you too. We bump into each other quite a bit. Are you also traveling? Yeah, you might say that. Are you headed the same way we are? Maybe we can travel together. Hikaru, we're on a quest to save the world here. This trip involves great risk. He's right, Hikaru. We can't be responsible for the safety of that kid. Alright, alright. Oh well, sorry, Shorty. Hope to see you again sometime. Like I travel with him anyway. And who's she calling Shorty? That kid's up to something. I can't just leap into the ocean? Alright, well, That's enough exploring Taplon for right now. Umi ran off somewhere. He's just, entranced by the ocean, I suppose. Oh, there she is. Alright, well, tune in tomorrow. We will explore more of Taplon and, figure out the mystery of where that fisherman went. Goodbye.